Hello and welcome to a daily run with Lilith. Yesterday's was entertaining, wasn't it? Let's see if we can get a little bit further today than we did yesterday. It's an XL floor, which means we really, really want to avoid taking any... Oh god, spiders. Help. Nope. That was close. Red heart damage, because this is our deal with the devil floor. Normally we have at least one floor where we're guaranteed no deal with the devil. A bomb would be nicer. I'm not even going to spend the coin. That's just bullshit, man. Bullshit. Normally we're guaranteed at least one floor where we don't have to worry about our red hearts, where we can maybe gather some spirit hearts and get ourselves some protection. But as Lilith, we do start with the two black hearts here anyway. So if we can get it as far as we can without taking any damage at all, we obviously give ourselves that advantage over the double boss fight that's coming up ahead to get ourselves that deal with the devil and sell our single HP, which is a little bit scary, trying to roll on spirit hearts, which is what we did yesterday. But yesterday, of course, we didn't die from lack of skill. We died from... spoilers, in case you haven't watched it. We died from what I would probably call a brain fart. An XL early floor is not too bad, because they don't get overly large. Okay, we should take this. I was wondering whether maybe we should leave this behind, just in case the deal with the devil has a two-heart deal in it. We could have got it for half price, basically, by not having two hearts. Careful. Oh, we haven't got a charge yet. I tried to use my charge, but it's not ready. Ah, that was dumb. Well, there's our first damage. It was kind of expected, because these spiders can be a bit tricksy to dodge around. Especially with these flies sort of taking control of a large area, because they keep following me around. And the spider webs, of course, slowing me down. I think at this stage of the game, I'm just trying to spread out the damage. This is very similar to the failures I do in the Darkest Dungeon, where you spread damage around amongst many things, and then there are still many things, all of which hit you. So what you really want to be doing is focusing things down where possible. Trouble is, in Isaac, you are responsible for your own dodging, rather than relying on dice rolls to prevent things from hitting you. There's a curse room as well. Excuse me. Thank you. The curse room is tempting, but not necessarily a very good idea, but phew, that was scary. Half a red heart is not useful at this stage. And I'm expecting the boss fight to be basically around the corner, which is why I'm not using the box of friends to produce... That was really bad. To produce more friends, so at least I got everything out of the way. We should not use this in case it's a bad trip pill, which would really ruin everything for the rest of the day. Okay. I thought I was shooting that box, but apparently I'm not. What was I saying? Yeah, you are responsible for your own dodging, so getting rid of stuff on the screen is not as easy. Oh, really bad. I've forgotten how to play Lilith. It's been a while since I played the game properly. I don't really want to shoot all that poop. So, the Widow is probably not worth using the Box of Friends on. I played a couple of runs recently, which I've uploaded and you've probably seen. But before that, or rather more recently than that, in a longer time frame, I've not really been making the effort of playing Isaac. I've been playing a lot of Darkest Dungeon, and I've been sort of taking a lot of time off not doing anything at all. Which means, altogether, I've forgotten how to play the game. Oh my god. Well, it got rid of everything, but it's a really bad situation. This is a spirit heart or two, though. Just one, but at least it protects us in this room, which is only a pin, so maybe the previous room was the right one to use our box of friends on. It's hard to know. Obviously, this could have been the haunt, for example, or something equally awful. Ragman, maybe. The fact that it is pin means we're very unlikely to take any damage to get rid of this spirit heart, and we are guaranteed our deal with the devil. Mom's underwear. It is two single heart deals, I think. Do you take both? I mean, our fame's not that great, but it can help when you get hit, and Demon Baby is pretty cool, especially since we do have the Box of Friends. So I think I will take both, even though it's quite dangerous, and this is what ruined us yesterday. But I'm not going to go to the curse room, I'm just going to move on. Mostly because I'd like to have more than one HP at the start of this world. And there's Rotten Baby as well, which, with Box of Friends, is a very good item indeed. So we can have two Rotten Babies, or when it comes to Boss Rush, more than two. gonna have a lot of flyers on the screen despite not having the Guppy transformation. And we do have to do boss rush. Don't let yourselves get fooled there. We are definitely gonna try and do boss rush. We're also gonna try and do hush. So that kind of basically means we have to keep hold of our look down. Speed down, speed. Oh god. We need to keep hold of our boxer friends for as long as possible. This is a good time to have the boss fight, because that was bad, but at least we killed that one outright. We had our boxer friends ready and we didn't sort of overcharge it, or we didn't waste the charge opportunity. Because the previous room had no combat, so it had no charge for us. And we do get a deal with the devil, which I was kind of hoping would not happen. We can't take either of these because we don't have any HP. Unless this is an HP upgrade. It's a range upgrade. That's really unfortunate, but I'm not going to kill myself. I'm pretty sure the mark does not give you any HP value. I don't think it pays back with any HP, so we can't just take it. We have actually been to our item room, so we could just leave. Kind of tempted to, but I want to get a bit of exploration bonus. Because it is a daily and we need the points. Points mean prizes. Maybe I'll think about going to the curse room, but that would leave us on half a heart, which is going to make us even worse off than we were before we joined this room, floor. So, because also, it seems to me like the secret room is next to the curse room. So we will go to the curse room via the secret room if we can just find a couple of bombs. In here? No, but there is Samson's lock. I think has a similar effect to Bloody Lust. I'm not actually sure. I'll be honest. Maybe it doesn't. There is a second key. So we do have the option of... Ooh, that was close. We do have the option of going to that double key room and seeing if it's maybe a full roll rerun. Full run reroll. Yes, that one. Although... correct me if I'm wrong, but I have actually literally forgotten the last time we did this. Does a full run reroll as Lilith not get rid of your box of friends, but not your incubus? Because obviously Lilith can't get rid of her incubus. Ow. I genuinely thought I dodged that, so we're doing really badly in this situation. Which, you know, it happens. I mean, don't let me pretend like this is a unexpected or abnormal or something. Demon Baby, if you could stop shooting for a small period of time, because... I don't want these things to explode near me! You know, baby, no. We're okay. How the hell do we deal with this? We just run. Run away. Oh, I just bashed the microphone. Apologies to literally everybody on the face of the planet. We didn't get any bombs. So I'm gonna go and see what the dice room has to offer. The double key room has to offer. I said dice room. It might not be. It is, and it's a full roll rerun. I did it. We have got... what the fuck have we got? We've got quad shot. We've got... oh, for fuck's sake. We've got Curse of the Tower, so every time we get hit, we can produce a lot of bombs. We've got Polyphemus, and we've got that one there, which... the fruitcake. Which basically causes every single shot to be slightly different at random, which is not fun. We haven't got... our box of friends anymore. We do have the mitre, though, which is going to hook us up with... excuse me? Can we talk about what just happened? Because I have no idea. Do we have a chance of one of these being Ipecac? For goodness sake. We've got Polyphemus, which causes our shots to be extremely powerful up close, but I really don't want that to... I don't want to try and use that, because if we're close to a shot when it goes off, if it happens to be explosive, hello? We're going to have a bad time. Infested is fine, it's just a couple of spiders at this stage. Don't know what our HP is like, but I think we have two or three red hearts. Let's err on the side of two. Not a fan of fruitcake, simply because of the opportunity for it to explode like it does. The Polyphemus quad shot seems to be doing okay, and our rate of fire is actually really good for having quad shot. Ooh. Yeah, there's a lot of effects that can be randomized from. But it seems like most of them explode, so that's probably a bad thing. I heard a key drop. Shit. Help. Hide. Run away. Oh my goodness. I think we've just taken red heart damage as well, so... I mean, who knows, right? This could be great, this could be terrible. But I did it. I'm gonna get this key. And I'm gonna see... We have got lard. I think that's what gave us the 2 HP. Yeah, we've taken red heart damage. I'll go in here first. We do have 41 cents. Lard is the one that slows you down, rather than the one that makes you stompy, which is unfortunate, because I would like to be able to squish these rocks. Right, how long do these last? That's the important measure of a run strength. So how long these mosquito sons of a bitches last for? We do have the opportunity to stay back a little bit, because Incubus, we can sort of cause to be further back than us, but I'm a... slightly upset that we no longer have... Excuse me? Where did that go? No longer have the... box of friends. And because this floor has been so bad, I'm just going to leave it. Not going to wait for a key and try and buy something from the shop. Just get rid of that damn curse. Right, we've got a good amount of spirit hearts now, thanks to the old bandage just now. But we're so low on keys. But we're nice and quick. I've skipped a lot of the floor, but that seemed to work for us on the... I think it was the Samson run. Where we went nice and quick, we missed a lot of the exploration bonus, but we did get a lot of the, we did get to do boss rush, and that's obviously worth a lot more in the long run than the exploration bonus tends to. Oh, that's no good. Don't think I can reach those without just waiting for an ipecac shot, I suppose. I could keep firing and hope that an ipecac shot lands in the middle over there. Ooh. I'm not going to min-max the skull to that extent. Goodness me. Sounds like a lot of effort. Where are we going? I don't know. Probably not here, if I had to guess. But just looking at the layout of the floor here, I would say this is a definite no. We're here anyway. We've got a bomb, for once, so we still could not get to where we want to get to, so... Let's not concern ourselves with what cannot be, and let's concern ourselves with what must be, which is that we must get to boss rush and we must not die. Oh, hello, I didn't see you down there. Thank you for not jumping and landing on me whilst I wasn't paying attention. Truly do appreciate that. This is not a strong position to be in because our incubus, we have to get incubus in the right position to hit this thing without exploding in our own faces. That's fine. No, and maybe a small rock. Ooh, it is a small rock. Super happy with that. So happy that my voice has gone all high pitched. It's okay. Help, help. Having this trail of slowing tears is really helpful because we have slowed ourselves down as a part of the reroll because that's what lard does. It gives you HP but slows you down a lot. Do you know what? We'll go in the shop first. There's a chance there's a key in it. There isn't, but there's... Oh, there is. And the sack head, which... No bombs, please. Which we have previously seen is an outrageously strong... the soul is also good. Which has got spirit hearts associated with it. Sack head is going to give us a lot more points than we would normally expect. Because many of our payouts are going to turn out to be sacks rather than, well, not sacks. And the soul, ooh, I nearly walked into that thing because it was blending into the background in my wonky colour vision, making it look like it was, well, making it difficult to see. Yes, we've got Degar's runes, which is what we were trying to do in the other episode. We were really trying to get... an AWAS rune to pay out. Now, in this run, we don't really need to worry about that because we are going all the way to what I believe is the Blue Baby fight in the chest. But because it's not got a red border, we're on normal mode, which is probably why I've not died, even though I've taken some extremely stupid damage. It just means there's way fewer champions, basically. We can definitely take this, and we should probably take... Oh, yes. Right, this is really good. I'm very much a fan of that deal with the devil. We've got a speed upgrade. We've got 7 minutes. We're still not very fast, though. About 6.5 minutes. I think we'll be okay. I'm just going to come and explore a couple more rooms, see if I can get something decent out of them. Maybe... Excuse me. There we go. But what? I don't know. Maybe a couple of spirit hearts, maybe some more consumables. We've only got one bomb, after all. And anything that drops has a chance to be a sack, which is itself going to produce more value for us. And let's go and do this mob trap room now that we can, because that's more points there. We're quite low on score, considering we're on the depths too, so I think what we need to start doing now is trying to find ways of increasing that score. The range upgrade that we did get, which I didn't mention, but now I think about it, it's more valuable than at first it may seem, because it means that the Ipecac shots are actually going to be further away from us when they hit the ground. We've got a Hermit and a Two of Spades. Two of Spades could be valuable right now. Blank Rune does a Hagalaz, and another Blank Rune, which does an Algiers, which is not valuable, and doesn't give us a Blank Rune back. So we'll take the Two of Spades, and we'll use it to double the number of keys we have when we have an opportunistic number of keys, in order to get a decent amount of points, which I believe gives you as many points as it would have if you just picked up those keys. Try for a secret room here. No. Try for a secret room here. No secret rooms. We're not done too well on secret rooms on this run, but honestly, I'm just sort of playing the game. I'm not really thinking about points. The last time I didn't think about points and just played through fast, we did really well. Aha, and that's a spacebar item. So it's a guppy item and a spacebar item. Well worth the spirit heart it cost us to do that. I'm probably not going to play this particular chappy because we don't have any red HP. We don't have any replenishable HP, which I suppose is the point there. Which means we don't need to do this. Spirit hearts are not quite as replenishable because they don't drop quite so often. Oh, that was nice. I mean, basically red hearts drop way more often. Both of them, you're still relying on them dropping, obviously, in order to replenish them, but you know, red hearts are extremely common, spirit hearts are not. That's a black heart, though. Don't forget we got the Athane. Oh, we re-rolled the Athane, so I'd like a bomb to maybe see what's in that tin to drop there. Pins? What's happening here? I don't know. Hollows. That's fine. Nothing's exploded in our faces for quite some time. Which both a good and a bad thing, I suppose. Careful, don't step on the creep. Now, it would be nice to get maybe the... Oh, there we go. Forgot about the Curse of the Tower, actually. It'd be nice to get something like the battery, because whenever we do a large room, we waste a charge, because a large room will give you two charges. I'm just going to use the Two of Spades now, so I can get in here. And the mind. Okie dokie then. Well, we know where we're going now. We probably want to do the shop. But what I think I'm going to do, in order to expedite this a little bit, I always say expedite for some reason, which is not a word, and you know that. Is I'm going to go and do boss rush, which I think we'll do okay at. Wow, slightly too slow to make this sensible idea. I think we'll do okay at boss rush, and then we'll use the hermit to get into the shop to finish off the floor. Then we'll leave, because this is really the last time the hermit's valuable, except on the hush lobby where there is a shop. But I mean, that'll save us one key. You can expect that by then we'll have the keys we need anyway. I didn't get that bomb, but we are going back for it. It's not a big deal that we didn't get that bomb, is what I'm suggesting. And Guppy's head will recharge throughout boss rush as well, so we'll have flies to help us out. We did reroll all of our familiars, as it happens. It's probably Krampus, right? Oh, it's not. But I don't really like my shadows, so I'm not going to take it. Polaroid means we are definitely going to the chest. We're going to have to hurt ourselves to start this, which is a shame. I think I might want chocolate milk, because it gives me the opportunity to decide when I fire. Which is going to be useful because it means I can hit everything with one hugely powerful shot, which is what's happening. The reason that's good is that so far it's been a bad idea to sort of fire constantly because we keep getting hit by Ipecac shots and things like that. All this means is that we fire once every so often, which basically mathematically reduces the likelihood that any shot is an Ipecac shot. And of course that the shot is near us, because we'll have chosen our... Ooh, that was close. Chosen our moment to fire it. In case you were wondering, whenever I use the spacebar to activate Guppy's head, it does release our charge. Our shot charge, so I'm trying to make sure that I'm pointing at something when I press the spacebar. There's a spirit heart there, which is no point trying to get. We're basically one-shotting every single enemy, so this is a very quick boss rush, and I feel extremely vindicated about my choice of item right now. Please. No poops. This might be a champion's boss rush. Well, it is a champion's boss rush, but what I'm saying is I've only just noticed that it's a champion's boss rush, which means that the carrion queen there did not actually produce any red poops, because it was producing hearts. The hearts that... fuck yourself. The hearts that you can shoot and do damage to it. Champion version of Carrion Queen is slightly easier than normal version of Carrion Queen, which is interesting. Especially when you've got piercing shots, which we do, because we picked up Death's Touch. Can I just point out how we're currently producing huge, massive sides that come out of the front of our faces? Which are the colour of chocolate milk. We might as well take this. We do have the mind, so now that I think about it, we shouldn't have taken that, because all it does is cost us points. But I'm going to take Hive Mind here, so now we have even more powerful flies, and the flies, I think, will do the damage that our shots will do at the point of charge that the shots have when we let, like, when the flies hit. There's some more money for us, so that's nice. You can tap shoot, well, we've now got a we already had a trinket. You can tap shoot chocolate milk charges. But as you just discovered, or rather, as we just discovered, I just demonstrated, tap shooting those charges is not necessarily a good idea, because it hurts like shit. We've missed Boss Rush, which means we can't go back and get all the spirit hearts that were left in Boss Rush. And that's a small problem, because it means that I can't play this dude, but I'm going to play this dude anyway. Oh, he's going to explode himself. Alright, well, that's Curse of the Tower for you. It's not just my curse, it's your curse too. We have one guppy item. I think. We have two guppy items. Do we have a third? Guppy's head, guppy's tail. No, of course we don't have a third. We'd be guppy. What are you talking about? How long have you been playing this game? I understand your concern for my mental well-being right now. Obviously, asking whether we have guppy when we obviously don't have guppy is clearly a first stage of madness sort of thing, but that's okay, and there is a super secret room here, so I'm trying to avoid being where my shots are, but they're so slow that it's kind of easy to accidentally walk into them. Piercing shots does have the disadvantage, I suppose, that you can't shoot bombs away from you as a judgment. It's a coins judgment, so we'll just play it. See if we can get some HP or something. I really don't know what I want this thing to pay out with, to be fair. Oh, that's actually pretty good, yeah. That just means more sacks for us over time, I think. Because a luck upgrade is just more things appear as a result of finishing rooms, and having sack head means that we get more of those things being actually sacks. Which means more income over time in terms of consumables, because that's how sacks work. We'll go here. We'll do this room. It's not going to last long at all, so I don't feel bad about even commencing this procedure, and we're done with this room. We will move on. We are currently only at risk of our own selves. Every time I pick something up, it releases our charge. Probably should have gone in here first since that spirit heart was there. Loads of huge spiders. And, you know, we keep firing shots such that they land near us, and sooner or later those things are going to be... there's the AWAS room we wanted yesterday, by the way. Sooner or later, these shots are going to explode and hurt. We have enough time, I think, to explore this floor, because every single room is dying in one hit. Thus. We'll come back for that. I know where the dead ends are, and I know where the boss is, etc., but it means we can at least choose our battles, if you see what I mean. I think I'm alright for the tower, actually, considering that I get the tower every time I get hit anyway. We have a crap ton of flies, because we're beating the room so fast that we are actually making a profit out of Guppy's head, which is kind of rare. This is such a powerful run, and I can't imagine that other people have not also had this run this powerful, but I suppose we could have said that about yesterday's run as... Not yesterday's run. Yesterday's run was horrendous. The day before... I kind of don't want that now I think about it, but I've got it, so whatever. Maybe we can sell it to the deal of the devil on the wound too. maybe. Yeah, I thought that might be true of the run of a couple of days ago, but we still came 150th, so can't really complain. Generate as many flies as we can, because it's going to be helpful against the boss. If the boss dies in, like, one shot of the, well, if the boss dies before we can even fire our tears, that's going to be brilliant. Question marks is I found pills. Yeah, it's just even fucking more damage. Believe Curved Horn just doubles your damage, irrespective of any damage multipliers that you currently have. Normally only one damage multiplier applies. Except for this one. Pills. I took it. Ow. Pretty Fly is fine. Hematemesis is not useful.
Perks.
Perks is pretty good. Especially in future. It would be even more pretty good if this was a run where we had to try and deal with self-sacrifice rooms, but it isn't. Perks lets you play them twice as much, is what I'm suggesting. If I walk into a room, press the space bar, it causes me to fire and produce flies. I don't really need the hermit, got 15 keys. Okay. That went down well. Just like your mama. Oh, he went there. If I walk into a room, press the space bar, that causes us to fire into the room and produce flies at the same time. Rather than producing the flies at the end of the room, in which case we don't get really any benefit out of it, we might as well produce the flies at the start of the room. Like that. Now, I'm hoping for a deal with the devil at the end of this floor. Excuse me. We don't get a recharge in these waves. It's a minor strategy that I have decided to adopt, but it's working for me, so I'm going to continue. I was hoping that would be our final guppy item to make this run absolutely outrageously good. But it wasn't. So, sucks, I guess. I might as well pick up the coin. It's points, right? We'll go this way and do the cursed room. Oh, that was terrible. Every room's a cursed room when you have Curse of the Tower. Can't see where I'm standing in order to avoid being spiked. Yeah. So we've lost a couple of HP here, but that's pretty much okay with me. Still no guppy items, but again, pretty much okay with me. A range upgrade is okay with me, and an infested pill is also fine. Got the two of clubs with us. At some point, the two of clubs will just turn into a shitload of bombs, which will double the amount of points we have so far for the bombs. We'll go back. We could get those couple of spirit hearts. We might as well. No, you dumbass. What's happening? If you get hit by a bomb that Curse of the Tower caused, it doesn't cause another Curse of the Tower, which is good to know and good to sort of... This is good in general, but we did take a lot of damage just now. I'll take this, but I can't be bothered walking all the way back to that one. Undoubtedly, we will get more because we have the Mitre, which is one of the many things that our reroll gave us, which are beneficial. Many people would not have taken this reroll, and I do not blame them in the slightest for having done so. But I always think that if there's a reroll opportunity, I may have borrowed this philosophy completely 100% from Northern Lion, and, you know, that's fair. We're both Isaac players. We should share our experiences and ideas. Answers has no value to us. If there's a reroll room, reroll. It could turn out shit, but it's going to be way more random and entertaining than any run that you could put together yourself. Because don't forget, there are items that we have intentionally not taken. You know, I'm pretty sure very early on in the floor there was an item we avoided because we didn't want it. I'm thinking, ah, that's shit. That is a trinket, so I don't want it. Whereas, when you take a reroll, you put your entire fate into the hands of RNGesus. I got hit by something. Well, I'm not quite sure how. Okay, maybe it was an explodey. An explodey tier that got too close. That would make sense. Man, these fucking shots. The trouble is, now I don't want to sound like I'm complaining, but you've got to find something to complain about on a run that's this good. Oh, we should, the trouble is, there are enemies that have multiple stages. Pardon me? I'm fully aware that there is a secret room here. That's useless. There are enemies that have multiple stages, and those multiple stages are invincible sort of in between the stages. you dick. That they are. So whenever we have a huge shot like this, I'm not quite sure how exploding works there, but it just dies immediately. Outrageous. Yeah. I wanted to sell my HP, basically. The question is, do we take the Book of Belial? I think no, because the Curved Horn is so good. There are no more deals with the devil anyway. Wow, we used a lot of HP on that run, on that floor, actually. There are no more deals with the devil anyway. So the Book of Belial's passive ability to give you more of a chance of getting a deal with the devil is not valuable. Oh, okay, yep. More damage upgrade. Abel, carry. Another damage upgrade, and Abel is just icing on the cake, I suppose. And we don't need the damage from Book of Belial, because I should not have to explain why we don't need the damage from Book of Belial, so I'm not going to. We might come back and see what Undefined gives us. I think the speed upgrade is more valuable here than the... It's a slight speed upgrade, but it does feel that much better. The other one was a split shot, which we do tend to get anyway, just sort of at random. During the fight. During the... whenever we fire tears, occasionally some of them are have the tear effect of the parasite. But mostly... it's just... we're so slow. I want to be able to dodge between the Hush's... bullshit... tears, basically. Help. Like that one, for example. Having that bit of extra speed on this fight is going to be valuable because there's so much shit on the screen, and I can sort of stop firing at leisure, really. We do have the soul. I didn't really explain what the soul does. So anyone who's not familiar, what the soul does is it pushes bullets away from you. It pushes enemy shots away from you. Apart from it gives us a few spirit hearts. Ow. Yeah, do that. That was really, really good. Thank you. It pushes enemy shots away from you. Gives you a couple of spirit hearts when you first pick it up. But it's a huge benefit in this particular fight. As long as you don't accidentally walk into a shot that has been deflected by the soul and you weren't expecting it to. The size of the shadows on these tiers. I do have the mod that upgrades the size of the shadows on our tiers, but on everything. This is dangerous because we could easily get exploded by this, but I'm just going to rely on the soul here to avoid the damage. We did get... Infamy actually saved us a couple of times, and we should recognise that. You should always recognise when Infamy saves you. Pardon me? Oh my goodness me. Where did that all come from? There's our win right there. There's so many points in that. Unbelievable. Unbelievable, Jeff. I don't know what caused all those to drop. I swear, I really do not. You could maybe say that it was the Head of the Keeper effect coming out of Fruitcake, which is not unreasonable, I suppose. It's possible that that is exactly what happened, but ow. There's... I wouldn't have expected each tier to produce a coin for every single thing that it hit. Which may exactly be what happened. I don't know. Well, we won that fight already. Not just about fast enough to get away from that son of a bitch. I use Guppy's head. I use it again and again. Unfortunately, we didn't get much opportunity to use Guppy's head several times just now, but that's okay. We don't need the sun card because we don't have any red HP, so we might as well just use it. Maybe we get some points for doing so. There's a Yara rune, which I'm just going to use right now.
Yara.
Now we've got two of everything that's here. I'm going to use the two of clubs. I'm going to use the two of clubs. We have an Elge's Rune, which is useless. It's not completely useless, actually. Two of Spades, and probably another two of Spades.
Of Spades.
And Temperance card. Temperance. Which we can... we've got an Elge's going on, so we might as well get more out of this. I want to know when it when it's going to switch off, so I'm paying a bit more attention here. I want to be at the front so I can see the Elge's dissipate. This is bullshit, but we've already done everything that is time-gated. Vis-a-vis Boss Rush and Hush. So now we just make up for all the the... Oh, we've got another one, of course we have. We make up for all the rooms we skipped.
Two of hearts.
By collecting in basically infinite amount of points right here. And this could turn into HP. I'm not sure I'm going to take... We may get a perfo rune that lets us re-roll it. We may get a perfo rune that lets us re-roll that. So, you know, it all works out. So many sacks, it's unbelievable. Two are diamonds, and the magician card is not too useful, but... Why have I got, Alright, I've still got the invincibility, because in fact the blood bank ran out, rather than my invincibility running out. All the bombs in the world, there's a moon. I don't think there's a secret room on the hush fight. And then we'll probably just go buck wild and see whether we can get any bullshit synergies out of the undefined. I'm just using this as many times as I can. We don't get any points for picking up these
The hanged man.
Just we don't get any points for picking up anything actually. We're using it. A couple of hearts though, get points for those. Don't get points for picking up the batteries, is what I'm saying. But I'm doing it anyway. Credit card, great. That's not much use. Tell you what. Another justice card with an actual bomb this time. Spirit hearts are all coming back. Use this. Use this. Use this. Whew. So many more things, and then we'll go and get... I was kind of hoping for a perfo rune, if you don't mind. Credit card is not that. Credit card, credit card, credit. Oh, two of diamonds.
Of diamonds.
Moon. Death. We've basically got everything we could ever want. Oh, great. Let's blow this up. I don't want to spend any HP on it. There's no more algae runes. Yeah, we didn't get the perthro rune that I was hoping for, but... We made fun of that. Let's see if we can pick up that credit card and... I guess do something with it. Now we've got BOGO bombs. And a pill. Which is infested. And three more of these, which came from somewhere. But still no perfo rune. That's fine. Got a full card, which will get us out of something for free. And then we take this. Goodbye, Guppy's Head. You've done us proud. Hello, Guppy's Head. Thanks for waiting. I was expecting an error rune. But I'm not going to take it with me because... Wait, why not? Take it with you. It's fine. 35,000 points already. Didn't really look at Greed Butter or anything to see what sort of point range we're aiming at, but we know there's no way of getting further in the game than the game's going to let us, so... No, okay. Let's just head up to the cathedral and see where we end up. The chest should be fun. Because... We have a lot of keys, and there's a lot of opportunities to get items. We still don't have 99 bombs, which upsets me more than is sensible. Okay. Empty rooms in the cathedral is also fine. Again, we know there's nothing in these rooms, but we get the exploration bonus anyway. And we're not really sort of trying to get anywhere at any particular time. Just trying to finish the run before everyone who's watching gets bored of it. Which I'm hoping is not going to happen, because this is so much fun. Guppy. Ah, Cursed Eye. Don't think Cursed Eye really... I don't think it works at all, actually, with Chocolate Milk. I think Chocolate Milk wins. It's going to be our Perfo rune, isn't it? Hagalaz rune, could be okay. Moon. Awaz. Probably does nothing here. Best could give us is a...
The moon.
Best could give us is a crawl space, I think. Ooh. Spend a bomb instead of a key. Is it really worthwhile? Another fucking reroll. Okay. We got the mom transformation. We have mom's knife. We have mom's knife, fucking tiny planet.
Are you?
This is bullshit. And we lost Guppy's head. Oh god, help. We don't have far to go, so there is that. We've got my best friend. Punching bag. Scapegoat thingy. We've got... Well, we've still got our... Oh, we've got Dark Bum then. So that's going to at least try and keep us alive. Where do I get this HP from, by the way? Another two of diamonds probably does nothing. Speed down doesn't help. Yeah, the 6 rune rerolls absolutely everything, not just your run, it rerolls the entire floor as well. So we've got Darkbum paying out with HP right now. I don't know how to deal with this. We've got 2 extra lives for some reason. So that's a spider, Darkbum. Don't you understand? We have Betrayal, apparently. This is going to be extremely irritating. We also have Piggy Bank, which is producing coins whenever we take damage. How the hell are we going to deal with this? Not only have we got Mom's Knife Tiny Planet, which does this stupid thing. We seem to have Mom's Knife Twin Shot Tiny Planet. But also, we have Incubus because we're Lilith. Which means not only do we have this bullshit synergy that's always shit. Oh yeah, sure, I'll take it, whatever. But we have the bullshit synergy that's always shit, along with the second bullshit synergy that's always shit. What hit that? Can we talk about this? I ain't shooting, are you shooting? Okay. Sure, here you go. Hello? Where are you? I can see you. I see your shadow. Infested. Sweet. Bit more cash, bit more keys, don't really care. Speed down, not valuable. Hematemesis.
Hematemesis.
Nothing, but Dark Bum's got us hooked up, I'm sure. A black heart? Wow, thank you. Let's just try not to get hit. Again, we do have Dark Bum to try and keep us alive. But I mean, Mom's Knife with Incubus is shit, and Mom's Knife with Tiny Planet is shit, and we've got both of them at the same time. And we do have something else that's firing every so often. We've got Fate's Reward. We've got Farting Baby, it farts. Excuse me? There's damage there, but I don't recognize the source. I don't recognize your authority, damage doer. We've got little Gertie who can certainly help out, I'm sure. That's no good. That's no good, lad. Little Haunt there? Did you see Little Haunt before? What hit me? I don't know. This is very difficult. Mostly because I can't see what's happening. Oh my goodness. There's a dip. I don't want there to be a dip. There we go. See, normally you could use Mom's Knife as sort of a melee weapon. Not in this case. Oh, it's going to be difficult as well. Do you remember when we had those tears that filled the screen? That were completely unlosable. That were fucking Death's Touch, chocolate milk, everything under the sun. I'm thinking, wondering whether maybe re-rolling twice is probably pushing your luck. Especially since re-rolling once is generally pushing your luck. Re-rolling a second time is probably just taking it too far. I don't know why we have two, oh yeah, you stay there. That's perfect. I don't know why we have 2 knives. But I'd like to be able to maybe get, oh shit. That thing. I'd like to maybe be able to get some melee damage done because, ooh, careful. Ah, oh, I got hit. Kind of expecting it. Got Farting Baby is basically trying to block all of Isaac's shots here, which is interesting indeed. That was very lucky not to get hit there. I'm not entirely sure how we're going to do this. Guess we just hope for the best. Something caused him to change anyway. Maybe this particular chappy? We can do enough damage with Robo Baby? Why are you slow? I don't like it. It makes you unpredictable when you've got slightly different parameters from your normal situation. Go, little Gertie. Little Gertie, sort him out. Yes. We can do this. I'm kind of hoping for more black hearts over time. I was also hoping for the Guppy transformation as a result of the reroll. Whoops, I just got shot. That's straight up on me. Shit. Really need to try and get some damage done to this bastard. Fate's Reward is actually helping out quite a lot. Oh my goodness. Oh my goodness. Wow. So each of these rounds is taking a very long time to actually complete because I can't figure out how to hit Isaac. And when we do hit Isaac, as just demonstrated, we seem to do okay. I'm going to see if I can pick up this HP here and get some Spirit Hearts back from Darkbum. In your own time. Yeah, just one. As expected, but exactly what we wanted. I guess we don't have the mind anymore either, so on this floor we won't know where we're going. And it's going to be difficult on top of that because it's just completely, entirely... press the right buttons. Why are things exploding? I'm not pressing any buttons. Someone needs to have a bit of a talk with the old Isaac people. We've got a conjoined? Yes. So now we've got triple shot, I guess. So if we can get these knives to hit, we will basically one-shot the room. We just actually have to successfully get the knives to hit. We're going to be firing three knives in a circle like this. Fuck. We may die, but we do have two extra lives. And I don't know what they are. So I don't know what will be coming back at us. Can we just... Yeah, we'll take some HP. Maybe we should have waited on that HP until we had some idea about who we're going to be coming back as, because that HP could have been really valuable. Maybe I should have picked that up as well. Who knows? At this stage, I don't even know how to play the game. All bets are off. I have no idea what I'm doing, which I suppose, as usual, you don't know what you're doing. In this case, I specifically have no idea what I'm doing. I don't know how to shoot anybody. I found a secret room, so that's nice. Yeah, attack that. I don't know how to aim my shots. I don't know how many shots it'll take. Is this worthwhile? We did re-roll the lucky foot that we picked up a long time ago. Could just be worthwhile then. Blowing this up. Maybe get something out of it. That's going to take us to our other secret room. Sure. I think blowing it up is guaranteed to produce an item. We'll take the moon card and go into this one, which is a greed fight. Not really what I'm after, based on the fact that I have no idea how to hit things. I was very lucky. I'm not going to take the steam sail. You can't make me. Oh my goodness. What is going on here? Help. Wow. I happened to let go of that shot at exactly the right time to hit the enemies involved. So, I'm just sort of guessing that whenever I let go of the button nearby enemies, the arc, the triumph here is going to intercept the enemies and therefore cause them to be dead. Or this shit's going to go down. And then I'm going to run around using permanent polaroid invincibility to do damage with the knife that's training behind me. And we're probably going to find out what our first extra life is. Yeah, there we go. Finish room? Not finish room. It's Blue Baby. Well, we were already rolling on Spirit Hearts, basically, so why would we not continue to do so? Ah, shit. 99 bombs, and we have infinite bombs anyway, because the room gave us golden bombs. So, the floor did. The floor gave us golden bombs. So, there's that. We're going to be doing really well on swag bonus. Maybe re-rolling multiple times to prove a point is a bit too macho even for me. And I know I'm one hell of a macho dude. That's why you watch the content, right? There is creep, but I believe it's mine. Have I got a headless baby or something? Where is the thing that I need to kill right now? There you are. One more of those. So slow, but luckily, we managed to cause it to... got something? No. We managed to cause it to change mode just before it walked into us, so that's valuable. And we do still have the curved horn, which doesn't get rerolled. So our damage is basically doubled as a result of that. What are these all about, though? I have turdy touch, apparently. So, yay. And toxic shock is an excellent item. Fuck it. Beelzebub, now we can fly. Don't need to worry about creep anymore. Yeah, that's a lot better. I think we just saved ourselves by re-rolling. Re-rolling again, and then re-rolling the second one because it was shit. And we've got Taurus. So, if all goes wrong, I can't see the thing that charges up. Like, where the hell is our... we're Blue Baby, we don't have a incubus anymore, which means I can actually shoot from my face. Unfortunately, I don't know where my shot is charged up, because it's so small. And we have Gimpy on. And we have... It seems to me that there is a strong likelihood that our rate of fire is huge, or very low. Our period of fire is long. So we have to hold down the button for fucking ages. We might as well be looking for... Ooh. We've got Mr. Mega Bombs as well. So we're going to have to basically charge up for ages just to get... Oh, there's a room down there. We should do that room down there. Am I going to re-roll again? I'm going to say no. Because we have... Well, we're not going to lose our... transformations. But... we have flight. We have monstros along with something else that appears to be awesome. So we keep the mom transformation. We still don't get Guppy, I can't help but notice. The only thing that's wrong with this run, as it stands, let's just finish it, is I don't know when to let go of the charge. And that is not really something you can strongly complain about, I think. We'll put ourselves in here and try and do as much damage as we can with all of our thingies. It is done. This is over. We have won. I'm going to reroll again. We've got the fungi transformation. What would we have had? This. Can I cope with this? No. Well, how did we do? 133rd, that is also a really good run. I honestly think that re-rolling the run as many times as you possibly can is the way to go. Even if you lose, even if you do terribly, it's so much fun. We did get a huge damage penalty because in that intermediate run, we had no idea how to kill anything, and therefore everything which was still everything which still had all its faculties was able to hit us. But 133rd is a great rank, and I hope you agree, and thank you for watching. Tomorrow I hope to do at least as well. I think that's gone good rank, died stupidly, good rank. So tomorrow we can expect to die stupidly, or at least perform poorly, but I hope you will join me for that in order to at least ridicule me and hopefully join me in victory. But until then, thank you for watching once again, and have a nice day.